Hello friends, welcome to our channel Google Galaxy. Today we are going to discuss our two topics, corrosion and rancidity. As we discussed earlier, that oxidation is a process in which oxidation is a process when there is an addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen. We know it very well. When there is an addition of oxygen, we called oxidation, and at the same time there is, or we can say, when a removal of hydrogen, we also called as oxidation. This oxidation has damaging effect on metals around us and food around us. We called also as eatables. This eaten up of this oxidation has a negative effect on our metals and food, which we observe in our daily life. We are going to describe these two effects by the process of oxidation in somewhat detail. When we talk about the corrosion is a process in which metals are eaten up gradually by the action of air and moisture, or we can say a chemical. So how we can define the corrosion? Corrosion is a process when there is a eaten up of metals gradually by the action of, remember one thing, the action may be gradually or somehow fast, by the action of, we can say, air, moisture, or by a particular chemical. When this includes, we called that corrosion is happening on the surface. Corrosion is basically caused by the oxidation of metals with the oxygen in air. Rusting of iron metal is the most common form of corrosion. So what is the most common form of corrosion? Is rusting of iron. This one is the best example we have seen in our daily life. Rusting of iron is an example for corrosion. When an iron object is left in the damp air, or we can say moist air, for a considerable time, it get converted into red brown flaky substance, or we can say in red brown like substance. So we call this substance as rust. So this is what we call rusting of iron. During the corrosion, or we can say rusting of iron, iron metal is get oxidized by the oxygen in air in the presence of water to form rust. So how we can say, we have left piece of iron in the presence of oxygen, we can left a piece of iron in exposed air. Also includes it may be some rain, it may be some water molecules. When these water molecules get attached with the oxygen, and further both will react with the metal, we call this a formation of rust. So what is the formula for the rust? You need not to just remember it formula, you can also write rust and teacher will award you marks for it. So here X dot H2O. So here, what does X represent? Here X represent that the water molecules changes with the condition. varies with the condition. So we call this one as corrosion. Rust is a basically a soft porous substance which is gradually fall off from the surface of iron object, and then iron below starts rusting. So we can say rusting of iron which is not prevented in time. If we not prevent it in time, it will automatically eaten up by the action of oxygen and the water. This is all about the corrosion. So what is the reason behind the corrosion? The corrosion will cause the corrosion will weaken the iron, steel objects and their structures such as railing, car bodies, bridges or we can say ships, and cut short their life. So we need to avoid the corrosion. What about the rancidity? Rancidities are nothing but an oxidation on the food items, or we can say eatables. The condition produced by the oxidation of fats. We have so many eatables around us. When the food material prepared in fat and oils and are kept for long time, they start giving unpleasant smell or taste. So what is the reason behind the unpleasant smell and taste? We say that food is oxidized. So what does oxidized means? There is an addition of oxygen in the and in the presence of moisture. In the presence of moisture, this both will cause, both will produce, this oxidation will produce the unpleasant smell and taste. Due to the smell and taste of food material containing fats and oils change and become very unpleasant. So how we can slow down the process of rancidity, or how we can avoid the process of rancidity? If we are having the chips, we can avoid it by using the nitrogen gas. We are having so many oil making chips, so we need to just add the antioxidant. We have to just antioxidant, that is against oxidant, that helps to prevent the oxidation with the help of water and the moisture. So another point is, or we can use refrigerator to avoid this rancidity. We can keep the food in the refrigerator to avoid this process of rancidity, because in the refrigerator when we kept the food, the oxidation of fat and oils become slowed down due to the low temperature. So the development of rancidity due to oxidation will reduce enough. So also how we can reduce the rancidity? By keeping the food in airtight containers. This is another way of keeping the food safe from the rancidity, because it will reduce the exposure of to oxygen, and oxidation of fat and oil in food is slowed down. So development of rancidity is retarded. So another point is, we can avoid the rancidity by storing food away from light. Storing food away from light. When we kept away from sunlight, or we can say light, the oxidation of fat and oils present in food slow down. Hence, again, development of rancidity reduces enough. This is all about the rancidity and the corrosion. Thank you for the lecture.